In this part of the video, we will learn how to create 3D objects out of two 2D surfaces and how to use them as a basic structure for freeform modeling based on subdivision methods. Like in exercise 1, we just create a point grid, but now with 8x8 centimeters with our point cloud. I just go into point cloud, enter the first point 0x0, and I enter a length of 8 centimeters and a width of 8 centimeters and a height of 8 centimeters. And here's our point cloud. I already have it on a layer, exercise 3, point grid 8x8 centimeters. The next thing is I select my point cloud, I explode it, and I select my first row of points and add a sublayer. And just give this sublayer a color, in this terms again red. Then, sorry, this one, and obviously I have to move this to my layer. That's something I forgot. Next thing is I add another layer, but not a sublayer, because I'm already in the sub-layer structure of exercise 3. I just add a layer, layer 7, and I go into the points and just add it to layer 7, and I give it a color, for example like this orange, and I just select these guys, I take a layer, give it a color, and for example like this green, and just choose layer 8, and now I have to move it a little bit to see this better. I choose these ones, take a layer, give the layer a new color, this blue, and change it to layer 9. And for the last row, in theory we can actually leave it like this, but anyhow, I just give it a layer, I choose the color, why not white, or yeah, white is good, and change these to layer 10, and here we go. I will show you now a different method of how to create simple 3D objects like boxes. And I just go into surface and I just draw a surface, somewhere like this, and it looks good. And the next step, with string and shift selected, you can select the surface, and with your gumball activated, you can extrude this surface to a box. Once you created this box, you can still extrude other surfaces in this box, and I just select this one. And what you can do is you can just extrude this surface like this, and if you now try to select the surface, then this is still only one surface. Another way is of doing it is you select this lower surface and you go again into the gumball extrude option, and if you extrude it now like this and you hold your shift key selected, then you can see that you have created two surfaces, or depends on you can select all these surfaces, because now it consists of two parts. And if I just now select this surface, then I can again extrude the surface, somewhere like this. Or I just try, I can also just say that I move the surface, and you can just see the different methods and what kind of impact these actually have. Okay, I just select it and I will extrude this surface. Before I continue, I just saw that it is a good idea to create a new layer, and the name of this layer is exercise 3 design 01, and I select this one and I just move this to this layer. So we have it a little bit better organized. And the next thing I would like to show you what happens if a surface is tilted and you want to extrude it. And I just go to this line, and it is like this. My exercise is not about design, and here I made the same mistake that I have this twisted surface, so just delete it, sorry, this one, and I go again into surface, select these points. By the way, I don't want to do this, I just stop one position earlier. Okay, and two options. If I select this surface again with string shift, I can extrude it with the gumball, and then you can see that the extrusion is parallel to the XX or all the axes like X, Y, and Z. It just depends on which axis I use for extrusion. And another option you will find under box, and here are different kind of extrude options. I just choose extrude surface, and if I select the surface and I just press the enter button, and then I can extrude it in both directions, parallel to my normal surface. For example, like this. If you want, you can also just draw boxes without any basic surface underneath. Just go into box and I click my first corner, my second corner, and then I go down, for example, like this, and here's my box. So there are different kind of ways of how to do this, and I will just add some more boxes. And just add a box. Somewhere like this. And like this. And the next box create in this direction. And one down, and another one I create underneath. Somewhere like this, and really important, this is absolutely not about the design, it's just about learning some very few methods of how to create 3D volumes. What you can see is that I just created several objects. And I just take this layer and I just say right mouse click to this layer and just say duplicate layers and objects, and I call this union, and I call the first layer like seven objects. I switch off my first layer and activate my second layer, and I also switch off my grid points. Well, that's quite interesting. There were some objects which I obviously do on, not this one, on the wrong layer, and I just change this quickly. Okay, I move them all to my layer objects, and just think about I can copy my objects and move them to my layer union. I can also just say I delete my layer union and just duplicate this layer again and just name this union. This will be actually the same result, but just a little bit faster. So my aim is not to have seven objects anymore. I just switched the grids off, by the way. I would like to have one object, and what you can do, you can use a Boolean operation. I just select this object and I go into Boolean. These are my Boolean operations, and the operation is union, so Boolean union, and you just select all the surfaces you would like to bool, like this, and then I press enter. Okay, once I did this, I just select it again, and in properties you can see it's one closed poly surface. When you switch on the cloud again, this little X, this point grid, then you can see that there's one part which is just outside of my cloud, and I don't want this. What I do is I just create a box, for example, like this. And you can just see that the objects intersect. There's one thing. Okay, I think it's fine. It's on the same line, so we can leave it at this. Otherwise, if I'm bothered that my operation doesn't work, I can, for example, just expand the surface, and then you can just see it's a really clear intersection, and there's no overlapping side or anything else. Okay, anyhow, I just go into Union, and what I choose is difference. And the next question is select surfaces or poly surfaces to subtract from. That's this one. Okay, and then I have to choose a poly surface which I have to subtract with. That's this one. I press enter. And you can see that I just cut this lower area off, so everything is now in my point grid. Okay, what I want to do, I just want to subdivide it into an organic freeform shape like you saw at the beginning of this video. And there's a hidden function in Rhino which we want to use. And it's a function they're just exploring, which will be probably a part of Rhino 7, but you can already use it. And this function is called subdivision for mesh. So the first thing we have to do, if I just select this object, you can see it's a poly surface. What I have to do is I have to convert it to a mesh. I just enter the command mesh in my command line. And you can see that I can reduce and expand the count of polygons. In this case, it doesn't make any sense and any difference because my surfaces are just boxes. I just say okay. And you can see that we have two objects in my layer right now. Just go into my layer and I have my poly surface. I just click on my objects and my mesh. And for my mesh, I think I will just have a new layer. I just go into exercise 3 and just call it 01's mesh. And I just move this object to my mesh, and I will then select my layer mesh and unhide the other layer, so I only have my mesh in my viewport right now. Okay, let's try this new tool, subdivision for mesh. I have to enter this command into my command line because it's still not officially supported. I just enter this and I just select my object and confirm. I just say delete input. Let me just look at this again. And when I just do this, first quite impressive, but there are issues. It doesn't look exactly the way I wanted to have it because you can see these open areas. And if I just go one back with string Z and we have a look at our basic shape, then you can see that at all these points where my unioned objects just touch, but they did not really intersect, that all these points like this one, and this one on top caused my issue. So next we have to fix this. But before we fix it, we just want to see what my seven single objects do. By the way, there was a mistake. Of course, this should go out because this was about the union. So I just activate my seven objects again. I just switch off my layer mesh, and we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Interestingly, only 6 objects, doesn't matter. I just make a mesh out of this. I just enter the command mesh. And here we go. I just take this mesh. If I just select, you can just see that it just goes through all the options under my mouse selection. I just go into a mesh and I just create all my meshes. I just select all my meshes, I'm sorry. Somehow like this. And like this, I think that's it. Here's another one. Like this. And I think to have a better view here, I just create a new layer. There's also the option to isolate and to hide objects. I'm not doing this right now, but you can definitely use this. I will just go into a new layer. I'll just say exercise 3, 0, 2 mesh. Let's see, I didn't really think about this actually. I just move this to this layer and I activate this layer and I switch all the other layers off. So I now have my meshes. And they all are on my new new layer. Okay, let's select all of them and I just enter my command again, subdivision from mesh and delete input, yes. Okay, and this is what it looks like when my objects are not unioned. So if you want to have one single object and you want to have a nice transition from one to the other, you have to union this. Otherwise it's like this. Every single object will transform to a freeform, organic freeform object, and they will shrink a little bit, and the result is like you saw before. Just because I can't union meshes, it's only working for these polysurfaces, I just go back. By the way, I can just delete all of this because I don't need this anymore. I just activate again my exercise design objects and here we go. And I will make very few changes. I select this surface with string shift and I just move this surface onto this line so there is an intersection. By the way, if this grid is not fine enough for you, you can enter more grid points. Instead of 5, you can have actually 10. So this was an issue with this little surface. Another issue is this intersection. So what I do, just do it quickly to show you the result. I just again select this surface and yeah, do something which is actually not so nice. By the way, I selected two surfaces. That's definitely not what I wanted. I just move this up somehow like this, and you can see clear intersection. And there's another issue. This is actually that they touch. If you try this by yourself, you will also see that this is not working. So what I do is I just hold my shift and control key. I select this surface. I just change my viewpoint port to, let's see, double click. What is good to front view. This looks good. And it would make sense to switch on my grid now, and you can just see that I don't have so many options in my grid. If I move it to this point, it actually probably looks a little bit weird. Let's have a look at this in perspective. That's definitely not really what I want. So I just switch off my object snap and I just move this line back. Just select it now. And this is my line. Again, made a mistake. Okay. Somewhere like this, not gorgeous, but I just want to show you my problems and how to be able to solve this. Okay, double click on perspective. We're in again, and this looks, it's not nice, I know this. This looks for my Boolean operation and everything else much better. So what I do is I just go again into Boolean. I just select my surfaces, my 3D objects, and I press enter. Next thing, I just enter my command mesh to make a mesh out of this. Okay, somehow like this. Okay, here we go. I select this mesh in my selection menu and I move this mesh to my layer XSR302 mesh. Okay, I activate this, switch off this layer. I just do it to have a little bit better overview at the end of the day. So, oh, this also doesn't look good. That this is flying, this box could cause an issue, but I don't know. So I just selected, I enter again my subdivision for mesh, and we just see what comes out of this. Delete input, it's fine for me. And I just switch off my grid, and we see that this already looks much better. This is a completely watertight 3D model without any mistakes. With this subdivision, you can do very few more things. What you can do is you can enter subdivide. And if you do this and you select this object and press enter, then you can change the count. Count means it's a little bit less subdivided, or, so again, it's a little bit more subdivided. And this is important for 3D painting. It's a little bit more defined. It's a little bit more. It's a little bit more smooth. Just because it's still in beta testing of Wino, the maximum amount of subdivision is 2. Another thing you can do is you can just enter points on, somewhere like this, and use. Select this object, and you can just see that you have control points. And in principle, you can just reshape or shape this in a way that you can still work on your object. I don't think that this is a really great idea right now. I just go back. I also go back in terms of my subdivision, and we just have a look what this looks like when I go into point I, point on, if I only have a subdivision of 1 points on, and that's what I want to choose. And then you can see that I have less control points, and this is more interesting. So with this, you have the option to still shape this a little bit. I don't recommend this actually. I would leave it like it was, but you can shape the design and optimize it the way you would like to have it. If you want to select this object and you click on the object, you can just see in the menu that you have your subdivision and you also have your mesh. If you want to export it to 3D printing, you have to select your mesh and you just go into export selected. Has to be a mesh, very important. And you just say 3D printing, somewhere like this. And then say okay. You can't export your subdivision object. That's really really important. And of course, like with all the other exercises, you can just render this and just make somehow nice visualizations out of this. Thanks for watching.